Does this six times? Two more, and then it goes. Okay, so let's have a little look at the introduction. If you can see here, it's on the top two strings, the fifth string and the sixth string. Now I know there's gaps in between here. What you don't want to do is go 1 2 3 and then 1 2 3 and have a little gap in there. It's continuous. The reason why I put the gap is so you can just see it's in groups of threes. So the first two notes, the 7th fret on the 5th string and the 5th fret on the 5th string, so it goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and then you go to the 6th string on the 7th fret and the 3rd fret, so 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So it's important to be able to count in sets of threes as well as fours. So if you went, if you practice it in the sense of going 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, and then practice threes, 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3, you'll see that they're both continuous. They both don't have a gap in it, but it's just counting in different groups, because threes are not as popular as probably fours. If you're new to learning guitar, so you got. Okay, so the riff, if you notice here, I'll show you the whole riff, the main riff. It's all your fives and sevens, okay? So when you come to the fifth fret, anything on the fifth fret, use your first finger. And anything on the 7th fret, use your 3rd. So when you watch me play it, it'll look like my hand's doing this the whole way through this riff. So okay, so I'm just going back and forward with them two fingers. Okay, so once you grasp that concept, then it should be straightforward to work it out. So you're starting with your 3rd finger there, because it's on a 7. And I don't want you to get your first finger ready, because I don't want it to ring out. It's just all individual notes. So, and then the 4th string, it's the 5th fret. Back to the 5th string on 7-5. So you got. And if you notice here, it jumps up to the top string on the 7th fret. Then the 5th string, you go 5-7. And the 4th string, you go on the 5th fret. Back up to the 7. On that fifth string, and then here you're jumping from a 7 to a 7. What I don't want you to do is take off your finger like this, because there'll be a slight space there that won't sound good. What I want you to do is play the 7 on the fifth string, and then we're going to go to the 1 on the fourth, but we're going to roll onto it like that. So, and what you'll notice is when you roll, it will cut off the fifth string automatically, because you're rolling onto it. Okay, so that technique's probably used a lot when you're going from a string to the next string, but it's on the same fret. It's always, you want it to sound smooth. Okay, so, and then you've got 5-7 at the end, so of that little bit, and then the very end of this riff, it goes 5-7, and then a bit of a pause, and then 5-7, and a bit of a pause. So, 3-4, 3-4. Okay, that's the timing of that. So you can see that 5 there goes onto the 4th string. Okay, so this together I'll do nice and slow. Bit faster. Three, four. Okay, so that's that really. Then we have this this section. It looks like quite a lot's going on. It does it 6 times. Let's just focus on the actual power chords here. If you notice, there's 2 different power chords. There's one which starts on, they both start on the 5th string. This one's on the 5th fret, and this one's on the 7th fret. Now, when you look at a power chord, you've got to look at the lowest number to get your start note and then your power chord, because obviously if I put a power chord on and the next note, say for instance it's there, that's gonna be higher than this. And I know your eyes generally gravitate to the biggest number when you see something like this, so you might be looking at the 7 there. Really, you wanna be looking at the 5. So you got these 2 power chords here, the 5 here on the 5th fret, and the same string on the 7th fret. So it's 2 frets apart. So you just want to practice them 2 chords, because once you got this second power chord, it hits that 4 times in total. That's that second one. So you hit that one first, and then hit this 4 times. So the strumming for that, as you can see, the first 2 is down up. So that's probably the secret move you've got to get to for this to run smooth. So if you watch this hand, it goes down, up. So down, up. So in the space of a down and an up, this has got to go from there to there. Down, up. And then from there, they're all up strokes. So you got down, up, 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 down, up, 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 up. And if you were to count that, if you want to see it in counting terms, you will see the down is on the 1, and you'll see the ups are on the and. And you're skipping out the down strokes, which are highlighted in red. So 1 and 2. And 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and. So when you look at a strumming pattern and you've got the pendulum motion, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 are all your downbeats, and then up, 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 they're all your ands, and. So if you go 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and, so you're skipping out the 2-3-4 down strokes. I know that's going into a bit of detail, but it's important to understand what's going on rather than just always just feeling it. It's nice to know what happens with the timing. So you got, and if you notice, my hand doesn't stop this pendulum motion. So if you're a bit like there's a problem, just get your hand going, and then down, up, 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 down, up, 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 up. So that's probably pretty tricky, something to work on. That happens 6 times there. And then we have this little section here which follows the same as before, but you've got a little 9 in there. I'm going to play it slow a couple of times, so 9, 7, 5. So you got, I did a little slide to that 9. You can just go straight to the 9 if you wish. And then from here, your 3rd finger should be on that 7 there. And what happens is you go down to the 5, but with your 1st finger, and then put the power chord on. If you can see it's stacked up, and then you go 1, 2, 3, 4. That's with the red highlighted there. And then you go down to the third fret with the power chord and go 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you got a power chord here on the seventh fret, but it's on the fifth string. And then you put your little nine on for the power chord and you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So then power chords 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that line goes. Power chord 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then it ends up here, so power chord on the top. Fifth fret 1, 2, 3, 4, then the third 1, 2, 3, 4. And then go up to the seventh fret on the top strings still and go. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're back into your main riff. Okay, well, that explains everything. And let me know how you get on with it. Thank you very much.